guys, I'm here today to have a look at RIP version 2, a dynamic routing protocol, to see how we can communicate between sites 1, 3 and 2 over here. So we've got 192.168.1.0/24. Can we communicate with the 3 network and 2 network between in these routers, router 1, 2 and 3? Can we use a dynamic routing protocol to demonstrate this? So I've already configured all of the IP addresses as seen on the diagram. So if I hover over, for example, router 2 here, what I should see is I should see the configuration. So I can see that I've configured gigabit 0/1 with an IP address of 192.168.2.1/24. And I've also configured serial 001 and serial 000. Okay, how I can confirm this obviously is if I go into my router, I can actually, just if I pop this over to the side for a moment, if I go enable and show run or show running config, if you want to use the full command, I'll actually be able to see my configuration. So if I hit return, it'll drop me down one line at a time. If I hit spacebar, it'll jump me down one screen at a time. So we can see in this case, if I just keep scrolling down, we can see there's my configuration of gigabit 0/1, and we can see also the configuration of serial 000 and 001. You'll also notice just that because serial 000 has the little clock here, so this is the DCE side, you'll also notice it's being configured with a clock rate in this particular case. Notice that, for example, serial 001, there's no actual clock rate, so obviously there's no clock rate command on this side. So, looking at that, we can also have a look at, if I just escape that, and if I say show IP route. So at this moment in time, this router, router 2, only knows about the networks that are directly attached to it. So what are those networks? Well, it knows about, if I just move that over a touch here, it knows about the network here, which is this 2.0 network. This is directly attached on gigabit 0/1. And it also knows about this 6 network, which is out this serial 000 interface. And it also knows about this 5 network. So we can see this in these different connected routes here indicated with a C. So there's the 2 network, the 5 network, and the 6 network. But it doesn't know about the 3 network, or it doesn't know about, for example, the 1 network. It also doesn't know about the 4 network here. So how do we get it to learn this? Well, what we need to do is we need to turn on a routing protocol. And that's, in this particular example, we're going to demonstrate RIP version 2. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to, for example, router 1 first and start the process off on router 1. So in this case, I'm going to click on router 1 and I'm going to wait for a moment until it realizes that I'm clicking on it. And here we go. And what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to actually start to configure this. Now, before I actually configure the RIP version 2 protocol, I always like to have a look at the interfaces on the router. So I say show IP interface brief, or show IP int brief for short. And what I can see there is the configuration of each of the interfaces on this router 1. Likewise, I can see show IP route. I can see what networks it knows about. Obviously, it looks different from router 1's perspective because it's connected to a 1 network, it's connected to a 5 network, and it's connected to a 4 network. And we can see this in these connected routes here. Don't worry so much about these L links for the moment. They're just local identified links that the router knows about. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to run that command again. Show IP interface brief. Show IP int brief. And what I'm now going to do is I'm going to configure RIP version 2. So I'm going to bring in, go into conf T mode or configuration mode. I'm going to go router RIP to turn on RIP. I'm going to say version 2, and then I'm going to use the network command to actually type in the network. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to type in the network it knows about. It knows about the 1.0 network. It knows about the 5 network. And you can see I'm using my statements above in the show IP interface brief so I don't forget about any networks it's directly attached to. So what it's going to start doing now is it's going to start advertising these RIP learned routes out to its neighbors. So it's going to start sending them over each of these various different links. So now router 2 and router 3 are just going to discard them because at the moment they're not even talking RIP. So what I need to do is turn on the RIP protocol on these routers. So once again, I'm going to go show IP interface brief. And this time I'm going to say conft, don't forget that, to go into configuration mode, router RIP version 2. And I'm going to say network, and in this case, it's going to be 192.168.2.0. Then it's going to be .6.0, and it's going to be 5.0. Once I do that, I'm going to go to my last router, which in this case is router 3. I'm going to go into CLI mode, and I'm going to do a similar technique. Show IP interface brief, and I'm going to go conft router rip version 2 and network, and then I can pop in the networks that I'm directly attached to and that what I want to advertise. So in this case, the 3 network, the 4 network, and the 6 network. Once I've done this, guys, I will now have basically a working network. Before, if I tried to ping, because in the routing table, if you remember, it didn't know about, for example, from this network's perspective, the router 2's perspective, it didn't know about the 3 network, it didn't know about the 1 network. It wouldn't have been able to pass traffic. Now though, if I go into router 2, and if I take a look at its routing table, what should have happened is, I should have been able to exchange RIP learned routes. So how I can see this, if I go show IP route, what we can see, and there's also a more little command here, so I'll press return here just to make sure that I can see the full routing table. You'll notice though now, I've got some new routes. So I've learned these through OR, or the RIP protocol, so we can see here. What network have I learned about? I've learned about the 192.168.1.0/24. This is this network over here, and we'll notice that in brackets, it's basically said, with an administrative distance of 120/1. That means a 120 refers to RIP, the believability of RIP, and then the /1 means it's one hop away from router 2, which is this router over here. We can see it goes out router 2's serial 001 interface. This is this interface right here, so it goes across this route here, and the next top IP address is 5.1, which in this case is OR1's interface, which is this one right here. So it's also learned about the 3 network, and it's also learned about the 4 network over RIP. And the 4 network one is actually worth just looking at for a moment. You can see that it's actually put in 2 routes to learn about this network. So you can see that the 4 network is this network across here. So router 2 can either go this way to get to this network, or it can go the bottom route to get to this network. They're both one hop away, so what RIP is doing is it's going to load balance this traffic between these two links. So essentially, this router has learned about all of the different networks in this small, if you like, wide area network topology. If I go over to router 3, for example, I'll be able to have a look at router 3's routing table. So again, if I pop back here and if I go show IP route, I can see that router 3, it knows about the 1 network, the 2 network, and the 5 network with RIP. So in this case, it can see about the 1 network. Where is that? That's down here. So again, how does it know about the 1 network? Well, it goes out through its own serial 00 interface, and it goes out, if you like, at next hop to 4.1, and we can see that indicated here. So let's give this a simulation. Let's simulate this. So let's ensure that this indeed can happen. So let's try a ping test, if you like, using our real-time mode from here to here. And what we should see is the first one, sometimes this fails because of the ARPs. They need to ARP to find out the MAC address. But if I try that again, let's give that one more go. Hopefully it should be successful. And again, if we want to test this in our simulation tool, we can do so to actually see the path of how the packets actually traverse the network. And I sometimes like to demonstrate this in class. So we can see in this case, RIP always chooses the path with the least amount of hops. So that's why it chooses this route to get to this PC. Notice it doesn't travel around by through router 2 over to router 1 and to PC 2. It goes via the least hop. So that's the metric RIP uses. Likewise, R1, it's learned two paths, but it will always choose and put in its routing table the least cost path to put into its routing table. So in this case, we can see we've got a successful ping. So just before we go, guys, what I'd like to do is I'd like to show you the powerful nature of a dynamic routing protocol. So what would happen if, for example, the link went down between R1 and R2? Let's say we had an outage, and we can simulate this by essentially, if I go in here into router 3 in this case, go to conf.t, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go interface serial 0/0/0, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to essentially switch this link off. So I'm going to shut it down. So once I shut it down, you'll notice immediately, because I'm in simulation mode, what will actually happen is it'll start, RIP version 2 will actually start sending out updates to basically say, oh, there's a problem on this link now, send updates to ensure that you let other routers know about this. So if I go capture forward, these RIP messages should get sent out around the network to let other routers know about there's a link down. What's going to happen now, it's going to update the routing tables of these routers to say, look, there still is a path from, if you like, network 1.0 over to 3.0, but in this case, it's not that this isn't the best path anymore because this is down. The best path now is to go across to R2, over to R3, and then over to PC0. So let's see if that works. So before, you might remember, we had in the routing table, we'll delete that, and we'll go back to real-time mode, but what will happen actually now is, if we go back and look at the routing table, before you might remember, when we looked at the routing table for here, the route that RIP chose was going out this interface and going across here. So if we have a look at the routing table now, we'll notice that this should have changed. So let's just move this over here so we can see it. Okay, so I'm going to have a look at the routing table, show IP route. Notice that the one network now, look at the route it's going to take. So we'll notice a couple of big important things that it's showing now. You'll notice the first thing, guys, it has a value of 2 now to get to this one network. Where is it getting this value of 2? Well, this is saying it's 2 hops away. So from R3, how it needs to travel to get to this network now, it needs to travel through one hop to router 2 and a second hop to router 1 and then off to the network here. So you'll also see that the next hop via 6.1, so in this case it's showing this, and you'll notice that this has also changed the exit point from router 3. So rather than going out serial 000, it's going serial 001 out this interface. And we can prove this by using the simulation tool. We can actually do a walkthrough. So if we try to simulate from PC0 to PC2, and if we capture forward, we can see that it actually goes across this route. And hopefully, R1 at the same time has learned about the new route, and it will pass through again back to, and this is the really, this really shows in a simplistic topology the powerfulness of a dynamic routing protocol, that it can update routes in real time. Obviously RIP version 2 has its disadvantages in that it's not the fastest or it doesn't converge the quickest. However, if there is different routes to that destination network, it will choose another route and it will still be able to route to that, even if it's over more hops in this case, as we can see. Okay, guys, I hope this has been beneficial for you, and thank you for viewing. Talk to you later. Thank you. Bye-bye.